Cowboys, we were so raw. We had some dogs on there. I mean, quarterback position, receiver position, lineman position. Like, we had people from Houston. They were like a travel team. And we used to, like, go. We done been to, like, Georgia. We been to, like, Florida. We done been really all over the world with that team. Probably the funnest moment probably was probably national. We had fun. We ended up losing the championship with, like, that whole week was fun, like, you know, we had to go to school. That's the first, you know? We seen the alligator.
You football, how confident were you about your skills? You feel like you have it? Are you ready to go to the next level?
Yeah. Next year. 7th grade, 8th grade, I was on 18. I started running back, but I played both sides of the ball. But I started on both, but I played running back for most. I know 7th grade, I went crazy. I think we went undefeated, won a district, or whatever. You know, it wasn't no championship, it was just district champ. Middle school. Coach was talking to me at Everman. They was telling me, like, you probably gonna come up here and play varsity. I've been ready. Some people be like, nah, you too young, you know. You probably, you gonna get hit and all that. I really don't worry about that.
Now, you being so young, you were a freshman on varsity. How was that first year?
I was on a team with a lot of people I grew up with in this neighborhood or whatever. And I was on a team with my big brother. Like, it wasn't really hard. I mean, I think it was like my second day of practice, first day. I did get hit, but I was a linebacker. He was a lineman. He pulled and hit me. You know, practicing hard with each other, and they already like 17, 16, 18 or whatever. But we practicing hard with each other every day, so it was like in the games, I ain't really thinking about, ooh, he grown or whatever. I'm just thinking about, I'm finna play him like I do at practice, play my other teammates.
Now, did you get in the game? Did you get some playing time freshman year?
Yeah, I started.
Started the freshman year?
Yeah, I started at running back. Now, what's crazy was, I was supposed to start at linebacker, but I was asking the coach, it was Coach O. I was asking him, like, can I get some running back burn, you know? So, boom, I think it was, like, we played, like, Crowley. They used to be good. We played Crowley. And, like, they gave me probably, like, 5 carries. But I took 2 of them to the crib. I think it was next game, we played Stephenville. They probably gave me, like, probably, like, 6 carries. I took 2 to the crib. And I think game after that, coach was just like, nah, we finna use you on offense.
That was freshman year?
Yeah, it was freshman year.
I don't recall all that scoring freshman year.
You crazy.
Is that really happened?
Look it up. Look it up.
What number did you wear freshman year?
Four.
We call 49 sweep, and then they say, he's running sweep. Okay, that guard's going to kick out. The other's going to hit that summer gun running, right? And watch what happens. You understand?
Block him, KV.
Outside the leash. Come on. Hey, so press him, get the numbers, and then start going back in.
Let's fucking go. Let's go. What the fuck? 48. Oh, 49?
49.
So, after that freshman year, what'd you learn the most? What'd you gain the most from freshman year?
Probably that it ain't no game for real. Like, them boys hungry in high school, you know? Because everybody trying to go to college. I mean, and then I learned, like, you know, I'm getting older. I mean, that's pretty much it. I was still, like, you know what they call it, like a dumb freshman. So, like, I was still just, you know, doing me.
You say you feel like a dumb freshman?
Yeah. You know, that's what they call it in high school, you know, dumb freshman. Yeah, I was one of them. I mean.
So after freshman year, you left and went to Brewer.
Mm-hmm.
Explain, you want to talk about that?
Yeah, it was really just people in my head, for real. Like, you know, like somebody you've been to, like, you know, growing up when they tell you, you know, come over here, you know, we can do that, yeah. You know, they telling me, oh, we got him, we got them, yeah. You know, I've been into it. I mean, it wasn't really what people made it seem. I mean, like, the players was there for sure. But, you know. Another side of players is coaches. That's really, you know, that's where that messed up at. I mean, can't take that back.
Just didn't go as planned?
Nah. Heck,
so what'd you end up doing that sophomore year?
I was just really just, I mean, I worked out a little bit. You know, I was with you. But I mean, really, like, I ain't play football. I was just at school. That was the boringest time of my life. You wake up every morning, go to school. You gotta be on the field or something, doing something. Yeah, all they coaches left. I mean,
do you want to tell them why you couldn't play football, or did you?
It was UIL. That's what happened. Really, it was UIL, and then the head coach. he ain't like me. Bro. He ain't like me because I wouldn't change who I am. Really.
You felt down at the time, that was, you said, worst time of your life not playing football?
Oh, yeah, heck, yeah. That's boring. Nobody want to come to school and just, I mean, some people do, but not me. You know, I'm an athlete. You know, I just came off of freshman year, starting in varsity, so it's like, nobody want to come to school and just sit there every day, go home. That's boring. You got to, you know, I want to play some football, pretty much.
How did the Everman family feel when you left?
I mean, they still talk to me. They just, you know, they ain't really tell me much. They just, you know, they still, you know, Everman, it's family. So it's like, you know, your decision, I mean, they'll tell you, you know, we still love you pretty much. It was stuff like that. I Like, they still talking to me. I used to still go to that game and everything. We know it's still love. I just want to make it.
Turn up. Keeping my composure, never sober, never choking, always smoking doja. From if they getting over, got a muncler coat me, cause the kid the coldest. I ain't changed, I stay the same and maintain it. Safe to say the kid getting older. Forever gang, I'm never switching over. Made a lane and can't get over. I can't mess with rappers, they be bogus. Rather get a pack and keep the over. Big dripper, stand up in the ocean. Everybody trapping, we get losing. He ain't 4PF if he ain't got motion. Made a half a ticket, out promotion. Shout out Switcher, sweet, they keep me rolling. But if we catch the off, we got us over. Run around with Drake, like Rio Rio. I got some rats and I want some more. Still got them pass in the hood, call it give and go. Keep a main in the figure four. Let me when I want, I just come and go. Man, these rats getting too big for these skinny clothes. I
might boom, when you come back home. Junior year, they got you playing linebacker Everman again. How did it feel to come back? First of all, we worked out heavy that sophomore year to get ready for that junior year.
Yeah. You know? Heck yeah, we did.
We didn't know what you gonna be. We didn't know if you gonna be a running back or a linebacker. We were doing both.
Yeah,
they were doing more running back work.
Nah. Yeah, we were. Cause
we didn't know.
I mean, when I got there, you know, they happy. What was crazy, it was like, there was a whole bunch of new people. Like, just getting there when I got there. Like, at least half the team. So it's like, everybody really like, you know, a fresh start. I mean, they ain't looking at me no other way. I mean, they just told me, you know, we got a leader pretty much, you know? And you got to show them that, you know, this is where I'm staying, you know? That's it. We put in crazy work.
Now, what was, when you got back to Everman, what was the conversation between you and
the coach? Yeah, Coach Broom, he came to my house. He just wanted to, you know, introduce himself really and, like, you know. But this one, he was just the running back coach. But, like, he just wanted to, you know, introduce himself. And, you know, I was still playing running back, but it was more linebacker. Like, you know, he was still room for me. We ain't really talk about Brewer that much. We just talked about now. You know, that's what he lived by. Now.
That junior year, you're going crazy playing linebacker. Some games you had like 8 tackles, 10 tackles, 12 tackles, interceptions.
Yeah.
Some games you had 10 tackles and 2 touchdowns.
Yeah.
Was that the most fun you had playing football that junior year?
It was senior, but junior it was lit. I mean, it's really cause, you know, they really let me do, you know, what I wanted to do pretty much, like a linebacker and then go play some running back. So I mean, it was lit, like stat wise. Yeah, it was stat wise. It was crazy cause, you know, I had probably like 100 tackles with like I think 11 touchdowns on the season.
What was the accolades junior year? You made first team linebacker and first team fullback?
No. First team linebacker and second team fullback. Like, they labeled me as a fullback and I played running back. You know, that was crazy. They just had to give me something, really. That's how that was.
Because you had, what, like 12 tackles,
yeah,
touchdowns?
Yeah, they just had to give me something. I mean, I ain't think I was gonna get nothing for offense. I'm with the killers going to BET inside of Vino. Man, my city was going crazy with the priest of Chino. And free that nigga Meach, cause he the hood hero. Don't gotta put no point in, we know. Wherever that drama at, we go. We the neighborhood hero. We the neighborhood hero. That street shit, we don't apply to niggas with that tweet shit. Beef shit. Niggas said, fuck me, he ain't mean that sweet shit. Phone them, call the body, they gon' be there. Clock to his face, he won't eat it. Niggas snake me once and I'ma fall back. Niggas say my brother, but he snake me, what you call that? I cheated on my BM 3 times with my dog ass. She gave her number, I deleted, cause they all. We the neighborhood hero. We the neighborhood hero.
Week 1, senior year. Who'd y'all play?
Alton. 10 a.m.
Remember that game, it was like a funny 35
or 10 a.m. Hot.
I still feel that day.
Hot.
They low-key did y'all wrong because who the hell play a game at 10 o'clock in the morning on Saturday in August? It was two
teams that share a stadium. So, like, one of them had to play on Friday and one of them had to play Saturday. And, you know, JV and stuff had to play Thursday. So, it was something like that. But 10 a.m. was crazy. Like, bro, probably the hottest game I ever played. Like, for real. I'm under the bleachers, under everything, like heated, out of breath. I'm thinking I'm out of shape. It was just the heat killing us. The whole team was done. We won what?
I think it was like
14, 40 something.
Yeah, it was a blowout versus that 6-18. It was a very hot day. I think you could have had like at least one. It would have been like one something, 115, yeah. Two tugs.
No, I had 150.
150, one yeah. Tug. Did you get in the box that game?
No, I didn't. I just had 150, just straight on the ground.
150 on the ground. And then boom, we go to week two. Who'd y'all play week two?
Stevenville. No. Yeah. Who played week two?
Who'd y'all play week two?
Dang. Couldn't have been Stevenville. It might have been Stevenville.
Week two was Stevenville. That 62-61 loss. Lost to the state champs by 1 point. Just playing that game.
I had four touchdowns. 200 yards. But I mean, we ain't execute on a special team.
Now, what's going through your head when you got 200 yards rushing and 4 touchdowns? How you feel about yourself?
Regular. I was hoping I'd do that every game. That's really how I was feeling. Like, I see I can do it, you know, versus the state champions. I feel like I should do it. Like, you know, now that's my standard. You know, and it ain't nothing below it, only, you know, higher than that.
Game three versus Benton, 54-19. How'd that go?
I had like 100 and something in the first quarter. You was there. I think I had 2 touchdowns. Yeah. 100 and something in the first quarter. And like second quarter, I hurt my shin or whatever. So I didn't play the rest of the game. But like, yeah. It was crazy. That was all KB game, you know, number 16.
Game four versus Joshua, 48-7. Explain that game.
I think I had 2 touchdowns. One of them was a catch. One of them was a run. We probably had like 130, 140 rushing. Okay. That was homecoming. That night, I had one homecoming king. I mean, it was chill. I mean, I don't think I played second half, really. I was just on the sideline with the crowd, though.
Game five versus Dennis, 35-33. How'd that go down?
I think that game I had 4 touchdowns, too. And I had like 260 on the ground. That was a game everybody was going to go. That was a tough win, really. You know, I had to do to win that game.
Game six versus Burleson, 28-26. I remember you guys being up 28-7 in that first half. How that game ended up being so close?
We got relaxed. Like, we did that a lot this season. We got relaxed when it was up by enough amount of points. Like, we shouldn't have. Yeah, we got relaxing. I mean, we won the game, but it wasn't how we wanted to win the game. You know, that's like, I won't say a robbery, but it's some tension, you know, between us. So,
we game won eight, the game. Game 8 versus Summit.
Summit.
33-14.
Summit.
Is Summit like a robbery game or like?
I won't call it a robbery. I'm just say. It's two, you know, real good team with dogs on there going against each other. I mean, Summit, that was good. I ain't gonna lie. I probably had only like 2 touchdowns and probably like 60 rushing yards. They had a good D-line. They had some boys on that D-line. But we put that game out. I mean, everybody else on my team showed up, like Johnny, Jamari, Jerrion, the defense. Brazil, Kevin Allen, Howard, Scruggs, they all, you know, they all did their thing. So, like, I mean, I'm still being a leader, but it wasn't a big game for me, but it was a big game for me, you know? We won.
Game 9 versus Corsicana. I know it was cold that day. Explain that one. 52-3.
I think it was an hour delay.
Because it rained?
Yeah, rain and like lightning. And it was raining and it was real cold. And like, we still had fans there, like for real. And like, I was surprised with that, but like, I think I scored like third play of the game. I don't even know how many times I touched the end zone. It was probably like once or twice. But I had like over 100 something. But like, yeah, I probably ain't play second half versus that game.
After the game, yeah, over with I did. Clock 0-0. What's going through your head now?
Dang, this is it, really. Like high school, I felt like, dang, it was it. You know, that ain't how none of us wanted it to end. So like, you know, it wasn't really like hitting really until the next morning. I like, man, I just played my last high school game and like I couldn't even play 100% really, you know? And I couldn't, you know, finish how I wanted to finish it. But like, you know, coaches was telling me like, it just, you know, better things gonna happen to me, really. That's what they was telling me. So it's like, you know, one day rule, you know what I mean? You got one day to be mad about it, sad about it, and then, you know, after that, you got to erase it. So now we here. I mean.
So what's next for Eric?
College. For sure. College.
What do you want to do with your life? What's next?
You know, of course I'd like to go to the NFL. You know, I'd like to be a teacher, too. Probably go teach at Everman, really. Teacher and coach. You know, couldn't win a ring as a player. Try to win one as a coach.
So you got goals of coming back helping the kids in the neighborhood?
Yeah, heck yeah.
Tell them where you're from, man.
I'm really from here.
Where is here?
E-Block.
Folks don't know where E-Block is, man. Tell them, folks, where you from, man.
Everman, Texas, really. That's where I grew up. I mean, we used to play football on this grass, that grass, air grass around here. The whole neighborhood. Now it seems like I'm the only one in this neighborhood, really.
All the homies left?
Yeah. You know, I was the youngest. I always been the youngest. So, like, you know, we got some in college and everything. So, yeah, I don't know.
So, how you feel about your team, man? Any closing statements for your team? Want to tell them thank you or anything like that?
Oh, yeah. You know, I appreciate them. For sure. Everything. We was a real family. I know we gonna stay a family. You know, to the end, really. I mean, I expect them to do the same thing, but even better next year when we ain't there. You know? For sure, I hope, you know, the best for them, regardless. You know, it's E-Block forever. For sure.
So you're a Bulldog forever?
Yeah.
Respect.
For sure. Whatever. No matter what.
Think about it, man. Closing statements, man. Who do you want to shout out?
Shout out Coach Farrell. You know? He taught me a lot. For real. Shout out Miss Sid. She been there. Shout out Coach Tony. Shout out Miss Percy. That was my A-grade math teacher. Shout out Coach Poole. Without him, I wouldn't be here today. So shout out Zombie, man. That little boy. People with the whole bunch. Shout out my mama. Shout out my brother. Shout out Mike. Shout out Michelle. Shout out JP. Shout out Jadon. Shout out Kim. Shout out Jamar. Shout out E. Shout out Chris. Shout out Arnold Wood. Shout out E-Block. Shout out Coach O. Shout out Coach O. My boy. That's it.
Shout out our girlfriend. Yeah, before you get in trouble.